Hey guys, Grant here, just popping in to remind you that King of Random t-shirts are available for Christmas. Click the link at the top of the description to get yourself a Random Happens, Ignite the Fire Within, or Caution, Random Experiments in Progress. I don't know how long we're gonna have them, but they're available now, so go get yourself a King of Random t-shirt while you can. Hey guys, welcome back. I'm Nate. Thanks for joining me today on the King of Random. In our previous video, we showed you how to take zinc powder and sulfur and mix them together into a fast-reacting compound that could potentially be used as rocket fuel. Well, today we're going to show you how to turn that potential into something highly kinetic. Rockets made from pens. Rockets are a lot of fun, but they can sometimes seem a little daunting or tricky to get into. They have special engines, parachutes, launch pads, and groups of engineers who build them. Well, the purpose of today's video is to show you how to easily build a rocket at home that can be made for just a few bucks and in very little time. Here's the materials that we'll be using for this project today. The body of our rocket is going to be made from a ballpoint pen. Be sure to get the pens with the hexagonal cross section. The six sides will help you line up your fins. We'll need some cardboard. I got mine from a cereal box. A glue gun. High heat or low heat will work, some super glue, a straw used for stirring coffee, some foam earplugs, and of course, some of the zinc and sulfur rocket fuel from our last video. We have all of our supplies, now let's get building. The first step is to remove the back of the pen. On the pens I have, the back doesn't want to come off easily, so I'm drilling a hole in the back of it and using a threaded screw to pull the back off. Once the back is removed, you want to pull off the top of the pen and remove the ink cartridge. Put a small amount of glue on the top of the pen and put it back in the pen body. Now let's make our fins. Cut a strip of cardboard 5/8 of an inch wide. Once you have the strip cut, slice off 3 1-inch lengths. From one corner, remove a piece at a 45 degree angle. Once you've got 3 of these, you have your rocket fins. Cut a small piece of your straw about 1 inch long. If you can't find any of these coffee stirring straws, you can also roll up a piece of paper about 1 inch wide and 1.5 inches long. The earplugs will be used as a safety measure attached to the top of the rocket. This way, when the rocket comes down, in case it lands somewhere we weren't planning, it's less likely to break or damage anything. To be sure that our foam earplug stays nicely on the tip of the rocket, let's melt a small hole in the back of it. Holding a nail with a pair of pliers, quickly heat it up in a flame. While it's still hot, carefully use it to melt a small hole in the center of the back of the earplug. We've now got all of our parts ready, let's assemble our rocket.
Apply a small strip of hot glue to one side of the pen. Secure the fin perpendicular to the body of the pen so that the end of the fin lines up with the end of the pen.
On one of the sides between two of the fins, you'll want to attach your straw. If you're using a high heat glue gun, let the glue cool a little bit before attaching the straw, or it could melt. The final step is to apply a little bit of super glue to the tip of the pen and use it to secure the earplug in place. There you have it, you've now built a complete rocket. It's extremely simple, and at this point, the only thing left to do is test it out. We've got our completed rocket and our zinc sulfur fuel. Let's put some fuel in the rocket and see if we can get it to launch. Our rocket is now full of fuel. I'm going to put it on the launch pad and fire it off using the N64 controller built in a previous video. Don't worry, we'll explain how to make these igniters and our launch pad in our next video. All right, here goes nothing. 3, 2, 1. Oh, I see it. I saw it. I don't see it anymore, but I saw it for a second. I think it's gonna come down over there somewhere, if it hasn't already. Okay, that was really cool. It launched up really fast. Like, that took off like a bullet. I think I was able to see it up in the sky for just a little bit. It's a nice sunny day, and the reflective casing of the pen, I saw some glimmering up there. It looked like it turned a little bit in the sky, but not like, it didn't go crazy, it didn't launch off in a weird direction. Just up. That was a good launch. Several hundred feet up there, definitely. 3, 2, 1. Launching in 3, 2, 1. That did not go straight at all. Okay, that thing just takes off
Like a rocket, or like a bullet, maybe, I don't know. They launch up super fast into the air. You can barely see where they're going. You just see sort of a plume of green fire and white smoke, and then they're gone. And you can follow them a little bit, but I should warn you, often these rockets are sacrificial. They launch, and you can't really find them again unless they happen to go particularly straight up and straight back down.
I'll do my best to strike the drone down out of the air.
That exploded, I think. I don't think it went anywhere. I think it just... I think that was a good launch. That looked like it went pretty straight up. It went fast, because they always go fast. It didn't look like the pen exploded, which might have happened a little bit so far. Nothing, not a big explosion, but we've had some that kind of broke off and went wonky. But that one was good. I like that one. I want to see what that looks like from the drone. Made ourselves a little crater in the grass almost.
Dusty.
There you have it. We've now had several successful launches with these little pen rockets. These things are a blast, pun intended. To quickly recap how we built this, we took a cheap six-sided ballpoint pen, removed the back and the ink tube, glued the top on, added some small cardboard fins and a little guiding straw. Then we added a small foam earplug to the tip just as a precautionary measure so it doesn't cause any damage or injure anything if it comes down where it's not supposed to. Using the zinc and sulfur mixture we talked about in our last video, we filled the pen with the rocket fuel and launched it up. It worked pretty well. We did have a couple issues with rockets launching off sideways. I think most of those were caused by the guiding straw breaking off from the pen body. I might have let the glue cool too long in an effort to not melt the plastic, but I think that also made the connection weaker. Reinforcing the connection of the straw to the pen body seemed to fix the problem. This has been a great project, and I'm excited to show you how we built our launch pad and electric igniters in tomorrow's video. Thanks for joining us for this video today, and we'll see you in the next one. Talk to you then.
Ooh.
Okay, here's the rocket that like turned a 90 degree angle and just launched. I thought it went way more over that way. All right, in the words of Adam Savage, failure is always an option.
Hey guys, quick reminder that King of Random t-shirts are available once again. Just go ahead and click the link at the top of the description and it'll take you to where you can get one today.